Dear students, let's discuss application based question. First question is about framing formula of sodium hydroxide, ammonium nitrate, copper 2 oxide and ferric chloride using criss-cross method. It means you have to show the process. And the second one is to write balanced chemical equation for the given reactions. So first was that when aqueous solution of silver nitrate is mixed with sodium chloride solution. So silver nitrate formula AgNO3 aqueous for aqueous AQ for aqueous solution. We can write SOLN short form for solution as well, and NaCl aqueous solution or just solution. So when silver nitrate and sodium chloride are mixed, then a double decomposition reaction takes place, and silver goes to Cl and forms AgCl. AgCl is insoluble and forms white precipitate. This sign, downward arrow, is sign for precipitate. AgCl and Na with NaNO3. NaNO3 is soluble, so will form and will go in solution. Then barium chloride solution and dilute H2SO4. This is another double decomposition reaction. Barium combined with sulfate to form BaSO4, which is again a white colored precipitate. And remaining hydrogen and chlorine react to form hydrochloric acid. Means hydrogen chloride in solution form is said to be hydrochloric acid. These type of double decomposition reaction in which one of the product is a precipitate are also said to be precipitation reaction. So both of these are example of precipitation reaction. Though this is not needed to be written, but you have to write product and reactant and in the equation form, and also you have to write any detail of product if needed, either in with the equation itself, or you write a statement about this. Like if you write without white precipitate and sign, then you write when silver nitrate and sodium chloride solution are mixed, then they form a white precipitate of silver chloride. After writing this, you write the chemical equation. Writing chemical equation is a must, as it was given in question itself. And if you don't want to write the statement, then you can write the same information like the sign of precipitate and white color of precipitate in the equation. In that case, if you don't describe the product but simply write the equation, then also it is acceptable. Else you write, like here as well, you write when zinc pieces are dropped in dilute H2SO4, then we observe evolution of gas. Otherwise you'll write that it is a gas, so it will be ZnSO4 plus H2, as hydrogen is a gas, so make the sign of the gas, and because of this only you'll observe the evolution of gas in the solution. This solution, sulfuric acid, was in the form of aqueous solution, so zinc sulfate formed will also be in the solution only, and hydrogen gas will move out. Here, when copper iron pieces are dropped in blue colored copper sulfate solution, then iron, being more active, displaces copper and forms FeSO4, which is a light green substance. So it makes the solution, and it is soluble as well. So the solution gradually turns from blue to green. Either you write it, or you write in the form of equation only, this one is blue, this one is light green. And as copper is formed, so you will write copper, deposition of copper over iron pieces, or if not, then you write that in the form of statement. So copper is get displaced, and this copper will get deposited over iron, whereas color of the blue solution will gradually turn to light green. And then, then we come to question number 1, framing of formula. Let's omit it. Okay, first is sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide, you have to show the method. So, sodium hydroxide, valency of sodium Na plus 1, so valency is 1. This is minus 1, so valency of this is also 1. valency of cation to anion, anion to cation, this cross and the shifting of valency of cation to anion and cation to anion, anion to cation is said to be crisscross method. So we have to show this valency and the changing place, then finally it will be NaOH. As Na1, OH1 we need not to write, because if nothing is written, then it is understood to be 1. Then second is ammonium nitrate. Same way you have to show this one as well. Ammonium NH4 1+, so valency is 1. Nitrate NO3 1-, its valency is also 1. Then crisscross method. Finally, formula is NH4NO3. Third one is copper 2 oxide. So valency of copper is given in the question itself. The valency of copper is 2. Why we have given valency of copper in this? Because copper is variably valent ion. It may have one valency as well. It may have two valency as well. So either we write copper 2 oxide or we will have to write cupric oxide. Then only we understand that copper is having valency 2 for this. Then CuO cupric valency is 2. Oxide valency is always 2. Both are divisible by 2, so we divide both them by 2, then finally it become 1 and 1 only, then it will be Cu1O1, but 1 we need not to write, therefore finally the formula will be CuO. Okay, then the last one is ferric chloride. In this valency is given, though not iron 3 is written, but when we write ferric, then it means it is iron with valency 3. So, ferric chloride means iron 3 chloride. So, iron chloride. Iron's valency is 3, chloride's valency is 1. 1 and 3 are having no common factor, so they cannot be made smaller. Then, crisscross method. Fe1, Cl3. 1 we need not to write. So finally the formula has become FeCl3. That's all.